Hello people, this is Shalini Singh from Tinkerly Jaipur, and as you all know, ATL, that is Atal Tinkering Lab, it is the most blooming word in the field of education, where I especially speak of schools. And these days I have been getting lots of questions from people where they want to know about the ATL criteria, how they can get themselves registered in like ATL stuff. So in this video, I would be answering all your questions today. An entire video of mine could be divided into two parts. The first part, I would be discussing the ATL criterias and the back-end work which should be done before getting before setting for registration process, right? And in second part, I would be discussing all the registration, that is ATL registration process step by step, right? So, when I speak of ATL criteria, as you know, our country is very large and the topography varies, like, and the topography as well as demography, it varies place to place. Right? So, when I speak of general, the ATL criteria for general topography and demography region, it is the minimum area required for lab, it's 1500 square feet. You should be, lab area is required, 1500 square feet. School must have classes till 10th standard, and minimum strength of student, it should be 400, right? So 1500 square feet of area, and school must have class 10th standard. And the third thing is the area, like strength of the student, it should be minimum of 400 student, right? When I speak of Seven Sister region or Jammu Kashmir region, so in that case, the criteria becomes a bit different. The area, the minimum area which is required for lab, it is 1000 square feet, and the school, again, school has to be till class 10 standard, and the minimum strength of student, it should be 250 students should be there. When I speak of island group like Lakshadweep, Andaman, or you can say Lakshadweep, Andaman, Daman and Diu. Here also, the minimum area of lab, it should be 100, like 1000 square feet. And minimum school has to be till class 10 standard. And minimum strength of student, it should be 250. Right? So these are, in case your school fit in all these three criteria, then you are eligible for applying in ATL registration. Like you are capable of filing registration for Atal Tinkering Lab. Now let's discuss the backend task which you should do before setting for ATL registration process. So the things which you should require is, you must have school detail information. You should be aware of minimum 3 years of school data regarding each and every staff. Second thing which you require is principal mobile number linked with Aadhaar. You must have your principal's number which is linked with Aadhaar, because you would be needing this time to time and again, you can say, right? So you must have that number. You must have school UDISE code, the third thing. The fourth thing, you must have alumni detail and count. You should be aware how many students have already been passed out from your school, where are they, how they are contributing to your school, everything. You must have idea of each and everything. Again, the next thing which you require is 3 years of academic record. You must be aware of at least 3 years of academic record, including 10th percentage, 12th percentage in case you have, and all the academic records. Again, the sixth requirement which is required is 3 years of teacher's record. Like, especially when I speak of science, maths and computer science, you must be aware of how many teachers were enrolled for the subjects, what was their attendance ratio, and how they were dealing with the things. You should be aware of that. Again, the seventh point which you should be aware of is mentors' information to school. As you know, every school or every education organization is supported by mentors. So you must be aware who are the mentors for your school, what is their duration of visit, how they are contributing to school, everything. And the last thing which you should be aware of, like, your student participation in state level or national level competition. in last 3 years, how many students of yours have been regularly participating in a national level competition or maybe the state level competition? What kind of competition were they? How many did they come out with the participation, or were they the first, second or third rankers? So you should have all the detailed knowledge of these. Once the backend task is done, now we can apply for Atal Tinkering Lab registration. Right. Once you are done with the backend task, now you are ready to go. You are ready to file registration process for ATL. So what you have to do, you have to simply type in your address bar the link which could be shown over your screen, that is aimapp2.aim.gov.in. So once you'll enter, once you'll click on this link, you can see Atal Tinkering login page. It will be open, and as you can see here, we have two sections, that is login area and new user sign up area. So you don't have to fill anything now in login area. As we are a new sign up, we have to file a new registration. We would go in new user login sign up area. And there you have to enter your school email ID, the official school email ID which you use for general purpose. You have to fill over here. Then you have to give your UDISC code and the CAPTCHA code which is shown on screen. So once you are done with these, once you click on enter button, so you will receive a password or a code in the mail ID, the school email ID which you have given. So just go check your email ID and check your mailbox and copy the code or the password which has been sent to you. Again, you have to come on same web page, and this time we can fill information in login area. So in login area, you have to again give school email ID, the same one which on which we receive mail right now. Email ID, the password which is sent on your mail ID right now. And again the CAPTCHA code. Once you are done with this and once you click enter, a new registration form will get opened. From here, the actual process starts. As you can see, the entire registration form has been divided into four parts. That is, contact information of school, basic information of school, performance of school, and fourth is ATL related information. So we have to fill this entire information step by step, that is part by part. Let's fill the first section, that is contact information of the school. While filling application form, make sure that all information which you are providing is correct. And second thing, each section is mandatory to fill. It means you have to fill all the questions asked, and all the fields are required to be filled by you, right? So you can see in the first part, that is contact information of school, we have a box gets open over there, and the first thing which it is asking is school full name. You have to give your name of the full name of your school. The next thing is complete address of your school. You have to enter your school's complete address, the official address. Then state, you have to select your state. Then district, where your school is located. Next is PIN code. You have to give correct PIN code of your school, of your area. Next it comes school contact details. Here, point number 6, you have to give official email ID of your school, the same email ID on which earlier we have, which was used during sign up. Then you have to give official contact number, the official number of school which is required for general purpose. Next, it is asking principal contact detail. Here it can be principal or it can be head of that school, maybe the director. So you have to enter full name of principal, mobile number of principal. Make sure the mobile number has to be linked with Aadhaar. Next is email address. It means email ID of principal. From this time, it is likely to ask that contact details of vice principal might be asked by you. So again, in case of, if it is asked, you have to give the full name of vice principal, mobile number which has to be linked by Aadhaar, and the email address, that is email ID of vice principal. Till now it has not been asked, but it is likely to be asked in future. Now you have to give proposed ATL in charge details, like when we go for ATL, it is mandatory that there should be an ATL in charge, you have to provide detail of that. So first, you have to give name of your ATL in charge, mobile number, which has to be linked by Aadhaar, email address, like or email ID of ATL in charge, and UDISA number. UDISA number, it is of school, not a particular person, right? So now we have completed all the sections of first part, that is we have given the contact information of school. Make sure all the information provided by you is totally correct. And people, once you are done with the first part, once you have given all the information which has been asked, you have to simply click on next button, right? You can also save this information, but you cannot click on next button leaving the fields unfilled. First, you have to complete all the fields, all the questions which has been asked, and then you have to switch to the next part by clicking on next button. Once you click on next button, a new page gets open about basic information about school. Now you have to give your school basic information, right? So let's start filling this. Again, here all fields has to be mandatory. All the fields should be filled by you. The first thing which has been asked is year of establishment. Year since establishment. Here you have to state how much old your school is. Whether it is it's of 0 to 5 year old, 6 to 10, 11 to 15, 16 and above. So in whichever category your school lies, you have to just click on, you have to select that button. Again, type of school. Type of school, it means which category your school belongs to. Whether your school is centralized government, central government school, state government school, local body, private aided, yeah, private unaided, tribal, social welfare department or others. So you have to select the type in which your school belongs to. Next, board of affiliation. Which board your school follows, whether it is CBSE, ICSE, ISC, state board, IB or other. You have to simply click on the board which is followed in your school. Again, the third question which is asked here is, which area your school is in? In which area your school lies, whether it is rural area or urban area. So when you give all this information, it brings you on a next page. That is, again, here lots of question has been asked. So first is co-educational. You have to state whether your school is co-educational or not. Yes, boys only, girls only. You have to select category in which your school lies. Again, the next question is school grade offered in school. Like what kind of grade activity you follow, upper primary, secondary, higher secondary. Again, you have to give total number of teachers in school, the count, the teacher count you have to give here. The next question, total student enrollment of school. How many students are ready in your school at present? Total student enrollment from class 6 to class 10. Again, you have to give the strength, student strength at present. Next question is asking highest qualification of principal. You have to state your principal's highest qualification, where he is below graduation, he is graduate, postgraduate, MPhil, PhD or postdoctorate. So you have to select the category in which your principals lie. Again, you have to select stream of qualification of principal. From which stream your principal belongs to. Whether he is of science department, he is from maths department, he is from computer science, he is from commerce or any other. After giving principal's information, we have to give our ATL in charge info. That is highest qualification of ATL in charge. The ATL in charge, the teacher which has been made in charge of this entire project, whether what qualification he has, whether he is below graduation, graduate, postgraduate, MPhil, PhD or postgraduate. You have to select one from these category. Again, stream of qualification of ATL in charge. Your ATL in charge comes from which field, that is which stream, whether it is of science, maths, commerce, other. So you have to state that. Again, the next question which has been asked is select state, which place, what demography region your state lies, whether it is plain area, whether it is hilly area, it is island. So you have to state that. Many of like in most of the cases we have to select plain when you are dealing with like centralized India or south. In case of Seven Sisters, Jammu Kashmir, we say hilly or Himalayan region. Once you give all this information, again we have to click on next button. Before clicking on next, you have to just recheck the stuff which you have filled in. Just make sure you are sure enough, and again all the fields has to be filled. It's compulsory to fill all the fields, all the questions which has been asked. I mean, you are sure about the information which has been given on you. You have to simply click on next button and it will guide you to the third column, and let's fill the third.